Having the ability to monitor your car battery can prevent some unpleasant surprises. In this video, I'll show you how I assembled the hardware, loaded the software, and installed it in my car. You will need a Wemos D1 Mini, its power shield, and some resistors. First, I started by removing the power plug. I installed the smaller connector to make the hardware more compact. The D1 Mini can measure external voltage up to 3.3 volts by using a voltage divider using these R values, which brings it within the 0 to 1 volt the EDC can tolerate. To increase the 3.3 to 16 volts needed for the car battery, we need to increase R1 to 1.44 megaohm. To do that, we can add another 1.22 megaohm in series to get the total 1.44 megaohm. I did this by soldering a 1 megaohm resistor to a 220 kilo ohm resistor. I added shrink wrap and then connected one end to the voltage input from the car and the other end to A0 as shown here. I then connected the D1 Mini to my laptop to load the software. Make sure you pick the sensor bin version for the analog input functionality. I then resume with a typical Tasmura setup. Before heading to the car, I attach a long wire to the power input terminals to be able to connect them to the car battery. At the car, I open the hood and located the fuse box. I found the fuse box to be a safe and secure place to install my device. I first wrapped the device with heat-resistant tape to cover any exposed pins. You need this kind of tape to withstand the engine heat. Since the entire car's chassis is ground, I found the nearest screw and connected my ground to it. I then located the nearest connection to the battery positive rail and connected my positive power input to it. I then proceeded by calibrating the range of the analog input. I did this by connecting a multimeter to the battery and read the current voltage. In my case, it was 12.73. To adjust the range, I used the EDC param command. I then did some trial and error until my reading was close to 1273. Now it was time to close the fuse box and the car hood. Back in Home Assistant, I opened the configuration file and added a new MQTT sensor. The code is in the description below. After I saved, I restarted Home Assistant for it to take effect. When it came back online, I added the new sensor to the dashboard. Now you can use this sensor to trigger any kind of automation. I have it set up so it sends me an alert when the voltage drops below 12. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.